Welcome to part 2. Now let's design the electronics for the slider. Here is our stepper motor. It is a two-phase NEMA 17 stepper motor. It has a holding torque of 43 Nm. The motor rated current is 1.5 amps. Let's see how to drive this motor. Here is the schematic for your reference. Here is the A4988 stepper driver module. There is a preset on this module. Adjusting this preset helps in programming the drive current of our motor. My stepper motor has rated current of 1.5 amps. Adjusting this preset will internally adjust a reference voltage that configures the drive current. This formula helps in finding the reference voltage to be programmed to the driver chip. So based on this formula, I need to adjust the preset to 0.6 volt to configure 1.5 amps which is required for our stepper motor. It's better to do the configuration without supplying the power. Let's see if we have reached 0.6 volt. Alright, the current is now programmed. Here is the pinout of the driver module. You can see that there are two different voltage levels. 3.3 voltage is for the microcontroller logic level voltage. And the 12 volt DC supply is for driving the stepper motor. The pins A and B go to the stepper motor. We will not use the sleep and reset pins. The sleep pin is already in the logic high state, so let's connect the reset and sleep pins together. The DIR is the direction pin. Making this pin high and then sending a low to high pulse on the step pin will cause the motor shaft to rotate clockwise. The motor rotates anti-clockwise if we make the direction pin low. But hey, this is a micro-stepping motor driver controller, which means you could trick the motor to run in super slow speeds by adjusting the motor drive current by operating this chip in different step modes. We can put this driver in full step, half step, 1/4 step, 1/8 step and 1/16 step modes. The preferred mode can be set using the MS1, MS2, MS3 pins based on this table. For demonstration purposes, I have put the module under full step mode. I have connected the step pin to a toggle switch. Under this mode, I can move the shaft 1.8 degrees every time I toggle the step pin using a button. So to complete a single revolution, I have to press the button 200 times. Let's automate this thing. Let's interface this driver with the ESP32 microcontroller. This is the heart of our electronics. Initially, I tried with the ESP8266, but there were not enough I/O pins. And then I tried with the Arduino Nano, but then the memory was minimal to use the OLED display. ESP32 is a bit overkill, but at $8 a piece, it is still a pretty good deal. I'm also planning to make a wireless controller in the future upgrade, so ESP32 is ideal for it. It has a dual-core CPU, 520 kilobytes of RAM, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and a ton of other features. Alright, I have replaced the switch with the microcontroller. Let's see how to do it using the micro-stepping modes of the motor driver. First, the full step mode. It takes 200 steps to make a complete revolution because each step has a resolution of about 1.8 degrees. In half step mode, it takes 400 steps to cover one complete revolution. So each step has the resolution of about 0.9 degrees. In 1/4 step mode, it takes about 800 steps to cover one complete revolution. So each step has a resolution of about 0.45 degrees. In 1/8 step, it takes about 1600 steps to cover one complete revolution. So each step has a resolution of about 0.225 degrees. In 1/16 step, it takes about 3200 steps to cover one complete revolution. So each step has a resolution of about 0.1125 degrees. So with these resolutions, we could make super slow motion shots. Awesome. Next, we need to control the direction and speed of our motor in real time. And we should be able to select the options from the display. So I'm going to use a rotary encoder to do this. Some of you may think, why not use a potentiometer? It's cheap, right? Well, most potentiometer has a maximum of only 10 revolutions, which means you can't get higher resolution. But a rotary encoder has an infinite rotation in both clockwise and anti-clockwise direction. It's also easy to handle it in the software. There are many types of rotary encoders. We will discuss them in a separate video. But for this video, I'm going to use an incremental quadrature rotary encoder. This guy has 5 pins. 2 pins go to the power supply and 1 pin is for the push button. You can see I can press the button on the encoder. The other two pins are clock and data. Let's call this A and B. I have probed these two signals on my analog discovery too. You can see on the scope that if I turn the shaft towards the right, a series of square pulses will be output on the A and B pins. Let's take a closer look at these two signals. You can see that the two signals are 90 degrees out of phase with each other. For example, observe the rising edge of signal A. For every rising edge on A, the B is 0. At the same time, if I rotate the shaft towards the left, the state of B becomes 1 for every rising edge on A. So by counting the pulses and examining the state of B on every rising edge of A, we can determine the position and direction of the shaft, which can be used to control the speed of the camera base plate in real time. Fine, now it's time to connect the display. I'm going to use an OLED display because I may use the slider a lot in outdoor. In such times, OLED displays will be extremely useful because they can be viewed even in bright sunlight. I'm going to use a 0.96 inch display that has a 128 by 64 pixels resolution. We need 3.3 voltage for the microcontroller, OLED display and the encoder. But the stepper motor requires a voltage higher than 9 volt. So I'm going to use an 11.1 volt lithium ion battery that has 2200 milliampere hour capacity. This battery pack has inbuilt protection and charging circuits. So we will use a 12 volt DC adapter to charge this battery directly through its DC jack. We can supply the battery voltage to the stepper motor directly using the stepper driver, but to step down the voltage for the rest of the circuits, we are going to use an MP1584 DC-DC step down converter module. I will set the output voltage to 5 volt using the preset available on this module. This 5 volt output can be connected to the VIN pin of the ESP32 board. The 5 volt can be reduced to 3.3 volt using the onboard LDO. We could have adjusted the step down converter to 3.3 volt and connected to the 3.3 voltage line directly, but we can take the advantage of the onboard protection circuits if we connect it to the VIN pin. Alright, we can start assembling the electronics on the puff board. We are going to assemble the circuit as a plug and play type. So let's first solder the female header pins for placing the microcontroller board and then solder the DC-DC step-down converter. I have some space constraint inside the electronics box, so let's assemble the motor driver module in a separate puff board. Let's solder the filter capacitor for the driver module. Let's do the wiring as per our schematic. We can mark the pin names and connect the driver, display and encoder. Bingo, we have completed the assembly. Let's see a quick overview of programming this slider. We will use the Arduino core on our ESP32 controller. We already know how to adjust the direction and speed of the motor using the MS pins of the motor driver. However, I need some sophisticated controls for driving the stepper motor. So I'm going to use the axle stepper library to control our motor at different speeds, move to a particular position precisely, accelerate, decelerate, and even more. Here is our sketch. The required libraries are included. The name of the pins are defined. And then the pins are initialized as inputs and outputs. We will handle the encoder pins in an interrupt function. The Tink logo was converted to 128 by 64 pixel data using an image converter tool and then copied to the Adafruit splash screen code. Here is the LCD assistant tool. It supports a lot of LCD display. We can provide an image and convert it to a byte array which can be loaded into the splash screen code. The Adafruit GFX library provides us with the necessary APIs to put things on the display module. Initially, we need to show the main menu after a 1 second delay of the splash screen. Then, if the encoder is rotated, the corresponding selection is highlighted on display and a selection can be made upon detecting a button press event. So, based on the selection, a particular mode will be selected. For example, in the real-time mode, I will use the 1/16 stepping mode. The encoder position value is initially pre-multiplied by 100 to start at an average speed. and any further rotation of the encoder shaft results in a digital signal that can be used to increase or decrease the overall speed. The direction can also be changed if the microcontroller reads the negative positional values. The next option is the time-lapse mode. In the manual time-lapse mode, there will not be any pre-multiplier, but otherwise it's the same as the real-time mode. This allows even slower movement of the camera base plate. The fixed time-lapse mode allows us to set the time in hours, seconds and minutes. The time is internally converted to seconds. The speed has to be determined since we have to move 280 mm from one end stop to other end stop. I calculated the time it takes for the camera base plate to move from one end to the other at full step because we are adding some delay and other checks in between. I programmatically measured that at full speed it took 1407 milliseconds to cover 280 mm. So if we select a sliding time of 20 seconds, then the driver will be put in a particular mode and some delay is added to each step to achieve the desired speed. Apart from this, there is some code for handling the interrupts, code to check the states of the end stop modules, some code to scroll the display, and some utility functions are all here. That's it for this week. Do you like the project? Let me know in the comments. As always, you can download the design files below. Thanks for watching this video. See you again.